रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवत सिक्स कैंटो नाइन्थ चैप्टर वर्स नंबर 35। सो इन दिस द डेमी गॉड्स आर प्रेइंग टू सुप्रीम लॉर्ड श्री कृष्ण। द डेमी गॉड्स दे आर सेइंग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्स दैट the presence of contradictory qualities in you is not impossible for you. It is not, you know, something that is, that cannot happen in your case. But those who are philosophers, etc., they cannot understand through their empirical knowledge, which is fundamentally based upon the sensory knowledge. So they cannot understand this. So your activities of transcendence, even though you are experiencing happiness and distress, is verily confusing. It's very difficult to understand for those. But your devotees can understand this. So we are hearing the purport by Shri Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur, wherein at first he presents that Supreme Lord is Ishvara. He is the controller. When you say he is the controller, it indicates that Maya is under his control, everything is under his control. Therefore, his experiencing happiness and distress is, or it cannot be material. Because he is a controller. Controller means he is even controlling the three modes of material nature, controlling even Maya. Therefore, when you say that, so the so-called happiness and or the happiness and distress that you see in the Supreme Lord is purely, is not actually the material. Then he says, further he presents, saying that in Supreme Lord, he experiences happiness when he gives darshan to the devotees. His unhappiness is when the pure devotees, they are troubled by demons or some other persons. At that time, he has to accept certain, you know, assume certain forms or certain hardships. By seeing his devotees unhappy or distressed, he will become distressed. And he will become happy when he gives darshan to the devotees. An example gives, Vishwanatha Chakravarti gives an example saying that just like when there is drought, there is no rain, and when suddenly there is a rain, and the farmers and other persons who are completely afflicted with the scorching heat of the sun, when they see this rain, they immediately get blissful. In a similar manner, the devotees, those who are constantly experiencing separation from you, when you appear in front of them, they feel very blissful. Seeing their bliss, you become happy. By seeing the devotees happy, you become happy. Therefore, he says, that happiness that you experience is not material. The happiness that you are experiencing is principally spiritual. Then he presents a logic. He says, okay, you are saying so, but now why don't these philosophers or empiricists, why don't they understand this? Why do they not agree with this? So in reply, there is a word that is used, anavagahya mahatmya. My glories cannot be understood by ordinary persons. But how can they be understood? They can be understood by bhaktyaham ekaya grahya. Only by devotion, only a devotee can understand me. So we heard in detail how a devotee can see Supreme Lord. Then, why he is anavagahya, means why he cannot be understood by philosophers? Because philosophers or the empiricists, देयर नॉलेज इज फंडामेंटली बेस्ड ऑन फोर थिंग्स और देयर यू नो एवरीथिंग देयर स्क्रिप्चर्स देयर नॉलेज एवरीथिंग इज बेस्ड ऑन फोर थिंग्स. वन इज पॉसिबिलिटी और प्रोबेबिलिटी, मे बी और मे नॉट बी, मे और मे नॉट. बाई दिस यू कैनॉट प्रूव और अंडरस्टैंड एनीथिंग, देर इज नो श्योरिटी देयर. अदर थिंग इज आर्ग्यूमेंट. बाई आर्ग्यूमेंट अगेन यू कैनॉट यू नो एस्टैब्लिश द ट्रूथ. आई मीन द स्क्रिप्चर्स दैट दे आर फंडामेंटली फॉलोइंग दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन दैट इज हैविंग इधर प्रोबेबिलिटी और द आर्ग्यूमेंट और जजमेंट लैक ऑफ एविडेंस और फॉल्स एविडेंस. These are the things that their knowledge is based upon. Therefore, my dear Lord, how can anyone understand you with these things? It is not possible. So that is where we stopped it the last time. Okay, so then Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur puts a question. If the argumentative persons or the Lord himself were to say to the demigods, I want to understand more detail. Dekhun, asangati thakile vivader anavasar ki prakare hoibe. You see, if the thing is not rational, if it is not looking justifiable, then how can you say that argument is not required? You see, that which is very crystal clear, argument is not required. But that which does not seem rational or justifiable, reasonable, how can you say argument is not required? You are saying that our scriptures are fundamentally based on argument, logic, etc., etc. But they are required when things are not clear. Why things are not clear? Because Supreme Lord has the quality of, you know, anayor aniyan mahato mahiyan. He is finer than the finest, mightier than the mightiest. He has these contradictory qualities. Now, how is it possible? If those persons who want to present the logic, they say that you see that those things that are that cannot be that doesn't make sense, that doesn't seem rational. How can you say that argument is not required? That is the question. Now, let's see what is the answer. Tahate bolite chen uparato samasta mayamaye. उपरतो निरस्त होयाचे समस्त मायामय बोलिते मायिक पदार्थ समूह जेखाने तादृश तो माते. सो द डेमिगॉड्स हैव यूज्ड अ पर्टिकुलर वर्ड इन दिस वर्स दैट सेज उपरतो समस्त माया मायामय. ही हू हैज कंप्लीटली ट्रांसेंडेड माया. द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस इज द डेमिगॉड्स आर सेइंग दैट ही हू हैज कंप्लीटली डिनाइड माया. He who has completely transcended Maya, which means Maya may bolite mayik padartha samuha jekane tadrisha tomati. So transcending Maya or denying Maya means what? You are beyond all the material things. These material things, material mind, material world, all these things, they are changeable. They are under the influence of goodness, passion and ignorance. But you are beyond this. You are not in the realm of this particular Maya.
Vibhada shakaler Maya shaktir kajatva hetu evang tumi Maya evang mayik padarther atirikta vastu bolya ki prakare tomate vibhada prasaktir sambhavanav hoite pare.
So now the argument, the logic, the possibility, all these things are based on Maya. They are all based on material knowledge. Maya here means material knowledge. That which is based on material knowledge, that can give knowledge about material things only. You can argue about some material object. Sure, whether that object is there or not, whether fire burns or not, whether fire is required or not, whatever is material, you can present your logic, you can argue,
But that which is beyond the scope of material knowledge, how can you ever say that you can present an argument on this? So the question Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur raises is that that which is does not seem to be congruent, that does not seem to be rational, how can you say that argument is not required? The demigod's answer is argument cannot stand position here only because you are beyond material argument, material knowledge. So
jodi bolen dekhun taha hoileu তোমাদের দেবতাদের সাহায্যের নিমিত্ত সমুদ্র মন্ত্রণাদিতে পাণ্ডবগণের সাহায্যের জন্য সুখার্থে সারথ্য দূত্যাদি কর্মে যাদবগণের পালনের নিমিত্ত জরাসন্ধ প্রভৃতির উপদ্রবে ভয় ও পালনাদি কর্মে প্রত্যক্ষভাবে সকলের দৃশ্যমান আমার দুঃখ কী প্রকারে চিন্ময় সুখরূপ হইতে পারে।
So further question arises, okay, you are saying that logic cannot stand or material arguments, material knowledge cannot stand, but our question is, in order to help you at the time of Samudra Manthan, when there is churning of the ocean to produce, you know, Amrita nectar, he took your side at the time, whatever distress was coming to you, he took your side. Then the Pandavas, in order to help them, he has become a sarathi, he has become a driver. Means he has become Kurma, on top of whom the entire Manthara Parvata, the mountain needs to be, he took the load of it and then churning on top of it. Someone put something, such heavy thing on the back. And it's not just place, they are rubbing wound, rubbing on the wounds, what do they call? So then it will be more painful. But anyway, Srimad Bhagavad describes that it was just like an itching for Kurmadeva. He felt as if someone is itching him, that's all. He didn't feel the pain. But those who are presenting the argument, they are saying that you had to take such a load on your back. And at the time of the Kurukshetra war, you had to become their, you know, chariot driver. At the time of Dyuta, the gambling, again you had to, you know, help them. In the Vanavas, they went into the forest exile. At that time you had to help them. The Kauravas wanted to kill the Pandavas. At that time, again he helped them. And then, in order to protect the Yadavas, Kamsa's atrocities were, you know, raising. So he had to kill Kansa and he had to make Ugrasena as the king again, the king of the Yadavas. He enthroned Ugrasena. So he had to fight with Kamsa. There is Chanura Mushtik, Kuvalaya Hathi, the elephants. So he had to fight all these things. And then also to protect the Yadavas, he had to kill Jarasandha. He had to fight with the Jarasandha. Prabhritir upadrave bhai upalanadi karme pratyakhabhave shakaler drashyaman amar dukha. So, we could directly see, you are saying that he is not material. So, the argument that is being presented is that he is beyond matter. He is beyond material knowledge. But we could directly see that he is fighting with that and he is experiencing the pain, unhappiness, etc., distress, etc. Ki prakare chinmay sukarup hoite pare? How can you call it to be material or spiritual happiness? We are clearly seeing that it is distress and you are telling that it is spiritual happiness. How is it possible? You are saying argument is not, we cannot place argument, but the point is that it cannot be accepted as spiritual happiness.
তাহার উত্তরে বলিতেছেন কেবল এব ইত্যাদি আপনি স্বরূপত কেবল অর্থাৎ প্রাকৃত মায়া শক্তির অস্পৃশ্য বিশুদ্ধ অদ্বৈত রূপ হইলেও আপনার যে আত্মমায়া বলিতে অচিন্তয়োগ মায়া তাহা অন্তর্ধায় মধ্যে অবলম্বন করিলেই
कोनु अर्थम अर्थः दुर्घटः कौन वस्तु आपनाते असंभव होते पारे. सो इन रिप्लाई इट कैन बी सेड लाइक दिस दैट बाय नेचर बाय योर स्वरूप बाय योर प्रिंसिपल बाय नेचर केवल मीन्स अर्थात प्रकृत माया शक्तिर अस्पृश्य विशुद्ध अद्वैत स्वरूप. केवल मीन्स हियर इट इज डिस्क्राइब्ड एज माया शक्तिर अस्पृश्य. इवन दो यू आर इन माया इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोटेक्ट द डेमी गॉड्स किल द डिमन्स टेक केयर ऑफ द डिवोटीज एक्सेट्रा यू आर अस्पृश्य यू कैनॉट बी टच्ड. Just like material example, a lotus is there, it remains in the water, but it is not touched by the water. Water cannot wet it. In a similar way, you are asprishya. You are in Maya. While staying in Maya also, Maya cannot touch you. Because you are Vishuddha Advaita Swarup. Completely transcendental Advaita non-dual substance. बाय प्रिंसिपल आपनार जे आत्ममाया बोलते अचिंत्य योग माया ताहा अंतर्धाय मध्ये अवलंबन कुरियाई मीन्स यू हैव आत्ममाया यू हैव योर ओन माया. वन इज मटेरियल माया एंड अदर इज यू हैव योर ओन माया. जस्ट लाइक आई थिंक द अदर डे towards the end you asked this question that when in the during Harikatha only this was raised that if Lord Ramachandra is an all-knower how could he not know who has stolen Sita Devi. If Ramachandra is all-powerful why did he make this happen in the first place, the stealing of abduction of Sita Devi. If he is all powerful, why did he take the help of the monkey army? He could have himself done it. So these things seem to be unanswered. He seemed to be in some kind of unhappiness or distress due to all these things. But here it is said that Atma Maya. You have your own Maya, that is Achintya Maya. Achintya means that which is beyond the reasoning, beyond the understanding of a human mind, that which cannot be understood. And you accept this Maya in order the pastimes to take place. Otherwise, for the pastimes to take place in the first place, he needs to forget his state as being called Bhagavan. He needs to forget his powers. He needs to forget that he is knowledgeable. So for his pastimes to take place without any bringing any opulence into picture or his Bhagavatta, his strength or name or fame into picture, he has to cover himself with his own Maya. Example, just like we see in the drama, in the play, somebody is acting on the stage or in the movies, and then we see that a person is crying. He's crying so profusely, seeing his mother dead. His mother died, or his brother or his close friend, he met with an accident and then he is crying. He is crying so, profusely. But then, as a seer, you are watching the drama, as a seer, you are also into that emotion. You are also really feeling that, yes, he lost something. But actually in his real life, neither is his mother dead, nor his friend met with an accident, nor is there anything. It's just an act. It's just an act wherein he has covered himself with a Maya.
Even a material actor in a drama or a play, he has covered himself with a maya. If he doesn't cover himself, if he remembers at that time that his mother is actually alive, why should I cry? Then he cannot act. he has to get into the role that his mother is actually dead. So here, Lord Ramachandra, or for that matter, any incarnation, when they perform this pastime, they get into the character. They have come with a purpose to give instruction to everyone that how one should act in, you know, he has, especially Lord Ramachandra has come to establish morals and principles and etiquettes, etc. So how in each and every circumstance he established that. That is what the lesson we need to take. And in order to give that lesson, he is enacting a particular kind of a pastime. And then he is getting into it. So he covers himself with his own maya. When I have my own maya to cover me, like an actor, he has his own maya to cover himself, why cannot Supreme Lord? But the only difference is that my maya is again material. And Supreme Lord's maya is spiritual. It has two sides. One is material maya and spiritual maya. As long as I am in this material world, the maya that I can cover myself with, already I am in maya. Already, you know, Brahmaji says that, what is that verse? Swapnabham astadishanam purudukka dukkam. He says that this material world is like a dream. Purudukka dukkam, and the sufferings are immense. There is immense suffering in this material world. Puru dukkha dukkham. And this is like swapnabham. It is like a dream. Dream is something, when we are actually into the dream, we think it to be real. But when we wake up from the dream, we understand, oh, that was the dream. Means it is not a fact. It's not a reality. It's false. In a similar manner, day is also dream. In the daytime also, we are living in a dream. What kind of dream is it? We think that this person is mine, this person is mine, this material world is mine, this house belongs to me, this bungalow belongs to me, or this vehicle belongs to me. This is also a dream. Prahlad Maharaj, in his prayers, in his teachings, he says, this is the thing that distracts me. He says that just like, no, it's not in Prahlad's, in Prahlad's instruction also it comes, that just like when he's teaching to his fellow friends, just like in the previous days, there used to be called as, there is a Sanskrit word to it, just like today we call as restaurants, a common point of meeting. So earlier days, they used to go by walk. When they used to walk, there used to be some junction points where water facilities and, you know, these things, resting places are available. So people from different directions, coming from east or west or north or south, whatever, traveling into different directions, when they come to those, I'm forgetting the Sanskrit word for it, when they come to that point, junction point, they sit together, they discuss, we call, modern term, we can say restaurant, okay. So they sit at one point, they get acquainted with each other. Oh, where are you coming from? What is your village? Oh, what's your name? And all these things. They get acquainted for the time they are there together. And then, at the time of separation, everyone is going in their own direction. But then, they don't lament that, oh, I lost my good friend. That was only momentary. For some time, there was that relationship, and then it is gone. So, Prahlad Maharaj says to the demoniac boys that this material world is like that restaurant place. We all of us, we have come here to meet. We are there for some time, but then during this time, we think that this belongs to me, this belongs to me, this is mine, this is his. All these things. This is maya. Another example that Srimad Bhagavat gives nicely, I don't know which prasanga it is. Srimad Bhagavat, it mentions that just like in the flowing water, the river is flowing, in the flowing water, you know, the grass you know, the dry grass, hay, when it is thrown into it, they are as a bunch. At the time of, you know, throwing into the water, there is a bunch. But with the stream, they get separated. They get separated and they get into different directions. But as they flow, sometimes in the middle they get, there is some stone or something. Again, they get accumulated at the stone. And then when the flowing stream comes from the back, again they get separated. So this is only a momentary time when they meet. But ultimately they have to get separated. So this is, but in this momentary period, I think that this person belongs to me, this is mine, or this house is mine, I belong to this material world, I and mine, this is Maya. Sapnabham, this is the dream, daydream. Night dream we understand to be false, but unfortunately daydream we think that it is reality. But that is also unreal, that is also not reality, that is also false. So, on one covering, we have another covering, Maya. If we can produce our own Maya, what is a magician? He is also doing some Maya, illusion, some act which we don't understand, that is Maya. If an ordinary person has his own Maya, that he can cover himself, if some magician is doing some tricks, all of us are sitting here. Unless we are not submitted to the magician, we will not understand how he is performing those tricks. If in this material world an ordinary person can perform such tricks to trick people, why cannot Supreme Lord? Why cannot he have his own Maya with which he can trick the entire world? It is his creation. If you can trick a few set of people, Supreme Lord can trick everyone with his own Maya. Therefore, you have your own Maya. Why I said all this is that, you know, Supreme Lord has his own Maya that he covers himself with, that is Achintya, that is beyond our understanding. And only those who are submitted to him, Mam Eva Ye Prapadyante, those who surrender to me, I reveal to them. Only to them I reveal. So, here the argument that Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur is presenting is that even though you are seeing directly that Supreme Lord is undergoing some troubles in the form of becoming a chariot driver, or in the form of killing Jarasandha, protecting Yadavas, etc., he is actually covered, he has covered himself with his own Maya, Atma Maya, which is Achintya. Aapnar je Atma Maya bolete Achintya Maya, Yoga Maya, taha antardhaya madhye avalamban kuriyai. So you are within that Maya, you are within your own Maya, Atma Maya. When you are covering yourself with your own achintya maya, means inconceivable maya, kon vastu apnate asambhav hoite pare, what is impossible for you? When you have covered yourself with maya, what is impossible for you? You can become a chariot driver, you can become a beggar, you can become a dog, you can become anything. Supreme Lord, when you have covered yourself, then what is impossible for you? Nothing is impossible for you. Or in another sense, that even though you are seemingly in some kind of distress by external vision, because you have covered yourself with Maya, those who are outside that, who can see? Outside your Maya, those who are inside your Maya, means your own internal Maya, you have internal Maya, that is Kladini Shakti, or your own Samvit Shakti, Sandhini Shakti, within that internal Maya someone is there, they can understand. But those who are outside on the periphery, how can they understand? Just like magician has his own set of persons. They understand, they know what the magician is doing, where, you know, the trick is. But those who are outside his submission, means those who are outside his Maya, they will not be able to understand. You have to submit to him.
So therefore, even though you are seeing, you are not seeing the thing as it is. You are not able to see the thing as it is. Even the material world also, you see, I think we heard this example before, that we are seeing a person. Seeing a person means actually we are not seeing what is within him. Isn't it? We are seeing him. It doesn't mean we know what is he or she. There is a lot of difference. Seeing and actually understanding. So in a similar manner, you are seeing that Supreme Lord is in some kind of unhappiness. Who knows? He is in supreme bliss. You don't understand. You are not able to see that. So your logic doesn't stand here.
अर्थात सुखमय आपनार अनुभवे के प्रवेश करते पारे.
Therefore, you are सुखमय, you are supremely blissful person, who can enter into that? I mean, who can enter into that means? What kind of logician can enter into that? Logic, empirical philosopher, or how can they enter into it? Not with logic, with submission. It's possible. If you want to challenge a magician, then he will not reveal his trick. You have to submit to him. You are my guru. I want to become your disciple. I also want to learn magic. Please tell me. Then he will teach you. But if you say, I want to challenge it. Challenge? Not possible.
एहि विषये कोनो कोनो प्रत्यक्षादि प्रमाण प्रवर्तित होते पारे न ए भाव.
So the conclusion is pratyaksha praman, that which is directly seen, cannot be taken as, you know, evidence in the case of Supreme Lord, because you are covering yourself with your own maya, which cannot be understood by outsiders. Therefore, it cannot be, you know, the pratyaksha, whatever you are seeing, directly witnessing, cannot be claimed to be a evidence here in the case of Supreme Lord. Logically, it is being said here.
Jemon skanda purane bola hoyache achintyo jaha prakritir par bhava shakal ke tarker dwara yojana koriben na.
In skanda purana, so it is said that which is achintyo. Achintya means that which is prakritir par, that which is beyond prakriti, that is that which is beyond nature, that which is beyond your perspective.
They said that
tarker dwara yojana kurvena, don't try to understand through logic. In Skanda Purana also it is said that which is beyond your knowledge, don't try to understand it through logic. Tarko apratishthat. By logic, you cannot establish truth, even material truth, absolute, supreme truth. Even the spiritual truth cannot be established with tarka, with logic.
Dekhun, achintya shakti svikarer kono prayojan nai. Amar bhagavat swaruper dwara bhagavat vatsalya janita sukh dukhadi युक्तत्व एवं ब्रह्म स्वरूपेर द्वारा सर्वत्र तटस्थ रूपे साक्षी रूपे आत्मारामत्व ए रूप स्वरूपद्वये यथाक्रमे द्विटि धर्म होक ताहते बोलते चैन स्वरूपद्वया भवात.
नाउ फर्दर लॉजिक इज बीइंग प्रेजेंटेड हियर. ओके, डोंट इवन एक्सेप्ट अचिंत्य, डोंट इवन एक्सेप्ट माय इनकंसीवेबल थिंग. You know, some may argue, you just simply say, you know, achintya, by simply saying, you know, inconceivable, you just put our, shut our mouths. Okay, let us not talk about achintya philosophy at all. Inconceivable thing at all.
You see, whatever happiness and distress I get out of bhakta vatsalyatva, of my having compassion or my becoming subservient or becoming slave of my devotee.
When, you know, the thing is, when do you have happiness or distress? When you have relation with someone. When you are related with someone, then whatever, you know, happiness or distress that person is experiencing, because you are in relation with him, you will also experience that happiness or distress naturally. Now, what kind of relation Supreme Lord has got? He has got with the devotees. And when devotees are in trouble, naturally the Lord will be in trouble. So, my happiness and distress that is coming out of my compassion towards the devotees. See, the compassion itself comes from distress. By seeing others distressed, you become distressed. That is why you become compassionate on them. Otherwise, there is no point of compassion. You become merciful when? When you can feel the trouble of others, then you become merciful or compassionate on them. So, my bhakta vatsalya, that means my being called as bhakta vatsala, means compassionate or, you know, friend of the devotee, itself means that I am experiencing happiness or distress. Because when devotees are happy, I will be happy naturally. That is coming out of Bhagavat Sarupa, my divine form. And the other, Atmaramatva. Atmaram means blissful, self-sufficient. Nobody is required to put him in happiness and there is no distress. He is self-sufficient, self-happy. That is called Atmaram. So, Lord is Atmaram. Actually, the entire discussion started because Lord is Atmaram and he is experiencing Sukha-Dukha. This is completely contradictory. He is Atmaram, self-satisfied. At the same time, he is also experiencing happiness and distress. So, that is why argument, logic, so many things are going on. So, he is telling that, you see, don't accept my inconceivable power. But as Bhagavat Swarupa, as in the my supreme personal form, I have Bhakta Vatsalatva. I am compassionate to my devotees. When I am compassionate to my devotees, then I experience happiness and distress. But I have another form, that is Sarvavyapta. I am present everywhere. I am present as Brahma Swarupa. Brahma Swarup means all-pervading principle. Now, I am present as all-pervading principle. That is my Atmaramatva. In Brahman stage, there is no distress, there is no happiness. You don't see any perturbation, disturbance or transformation, change or nothing you see in me. I am Atmaram, self-satisfied and self-sufficient. But in my Bhagavat Swarupa, in my form as a Lord, there I have this happiness and distress. So, still you cannot see any contradiction in these two. In my two forms, one as Brahman, I am Atmaram. In my other form as Lord, I am experiencing happy distress. So, why argument is required? So, Krishna Chakravarti Thakur is presenting so nicely that how these things are so verily congruent in Supreme Lord. They are all rational. They are very reasonable in Supreme Lord. Arthat tatvatah tomar. Okay, I will stop here because I don't want to rush into this. I thought I will finish this, but one more day we will take to. So, because these things are to be explained or to be understood slowly. Pancha kalpatarubhyascha kripa sindubhya evacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namah.